Previously, in part 1 of this project, I showed how I used a cheap USB TV tuner to eavesdrop on and decode my ceiling fan's wireless commands. Now that I have that knowledge, part 2 is all about sending those same commands using a Raspberry Pi. This isn't just plugging in some expensive radio into the Pi. The Pi itself, believe it or not, can transmit radio signals on a huge range of frequencies. Obviously, it has a radio for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, but that's way off from the frequency I need to transmit. What it also has that most computers don't have are GPIO pins that you can easily control. If we can toggle one of those GPIO pins back and forth between 0 and 1, we generate electromagnetic radiation in the form of radio waves. Luckily for us, there already is a tool to do this on the Raspberry Pi. It's called rpitx, and you can find it on GitHub. It can generate all sorts of radio signals in a huge frequency range using GPIO pin number 4. This works without us connecting anything to the pin at all because a wire that's disconnected on one end can still have current and voltage. This disconnected pin is basically an antenna, a very small antenna. It's actually a little too small because the radio signal only goes about 10 centimeters. I want to control my ceiling fan, but I'm not going to tape the Pi to my ceiling to make it happen. However, if I connect a longer wire to this pin, then I can extend the range. Here, I've cut a length of wire about 20 centimeters long. Again, it's not connected to anything. If I transmit using this, the signal can go tens of meters. A signal on a specific frequency is like this. It's a sine wave. But with the Pi's GPIO, we're working with binary data, ones and zeros. If we toggle between 1 and 0 at the same frequency, we get a square wave instead of a sine wave. In reality, it actually looks more like this due to physics. If we compare the two, here's the difference. Isolating this difference, it's equivalent to more sine waves stacked together. Basically, anything that's not a sine wave is some combination of sine waves at different frequencies. That means transmitting our square wave transmits on multiple frequencies at once. For a square wave, it's very simple to calculate these frequencies. A square wave at, say, 100 MHz contains not only a signal at 100 MHz, aka the fundamental frequency, but also at 3x the fundamental, 5x, 7x, and so on. We call these the harmonics. So the bad news is that anytime we try to transmit on a specific frequency with the Pi, we're also simultaneously transmitting on many other frequencies. There are a lot of frequencies that are illegal to transmit on without a license for good reason. You don't want your cell phone to drop calls because your neighbor is using remote control. The good news is that this is a common and well-understood problem. We can send our signal through what's called a low-pass filter, which blocks signals above a certain frequency while letting signals below that frequency pass through. They're not complicated, and it's very possible to build your own with the right resistor and capacitor, but I was able to find suitable filters on eBay for only $7. Shipping was pretty slow, but that's the price you pay for cheap electronics. For aesthetics, I'm adding in an antenna and a connector for the other end, and all this stuff adds up to about $15. Back to the software side, rpitx comes with a bunch of example programs, one of which is exactly what we need. We know that this remote uses on-off keying, basically Morse code, and there just happens to be an included program called SendOK. We just need to tell SendOK exactly what we want to send, including frequency and timing, and...
holy shit, it worked.
That was proof that I can control my ceiling fan and light with my Raspberry Pi. I can even throw together a quick web page on my Pi as proof that I can control it with my phone. The web server simply runs the SendOK program with the right arguments whenever you push one of the buttons on the page. At this point, it's just a proof of concept. In the future, I'll integrate this into Home Assistant so that these controls are centralized and integrated with all the other smart home hardware in my house. If you're using other systems like Alexa, I'm sure there's a way to set up custom actions as well. They just need to tell your Pi to run the right command. As always, I appreciate all of your comments and likes. If you want to see more of my videos on tech, automation, or whatever else I find interesting, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.